Quick stream before work today. I stayed up a little bit late, unfortunately. I feel like we need like hair cards or something. Sure that the proportions are all good. And try a different hairstyle on this guy. Different hairstyle. I've never used Snakehook before. It's always like a brush that I kind of accidentally select and that I never really practice with. Something like this. I kind of want to give him like a ponytail. Or maybe like some kind of like man bun. You want a man bun? Something like that. Give him some anime hair. Something like this. Yeah, I give him like some kind of breathing apparatus. I've been debating this a lot, whether to give him like a robotic jaw here, or just like cover up this entire area with like a kind of like a mask, essentially. I think I might go with a mask. Not because I'm bad at faces, but because I think it'll just look cooler. That's definitely the reason. There we go. Looks much better already. I'm still doing the human face. But, like baby steps, right? Man. Well then, I think my dog lost something under the couch. Yeah, whenever my dog loses something under the couch, I'll just sit there and whine until I go and get it for him. I think I'll make some kind of like, I want to say like Arisaka, kind of like a Japanese or Asian sort of assassin. An assassin of the Asian persuasion. Still a corpo, but with a twist. Is the face asymmetrical or is it? Okay, it's the mask. Something like that. Oh, why is asymmetry always turned off? What is going on? So what kind of hairstyle is this actually? Is this like a mohawk or? I gotta figure out this hairstyle a bit more. It's definitely like anime hair. And then it's gonna be like buzzed on the sides, I guess. So cool. Okay, so we have this half. What's up with this half though? What are we gonna do here? Is it gonna be long hair too? Or do something like that, I guess? Or is it swept back? I think we'll do like a sweep back here. Yeah, something like that. I don't know. Next time I go to the barber, when I have like longer hair, I'm gonna go give him a picture of this guy and be like, "Hey, I want my hairstyle to look like this guy." That'd be pretty funny. This is such a trippy tool. I've never really used this tool a lot before. I figured I might try it out for this, for the hair. Now we have to establish like where the hair parts. So I guess the hair would be like, use the move tool really fast. Guess the hair kind of like, it goes like that and then goes around like that. Yeah. So it's not a center part, a part on the side here. There we go. So now we've established our hair. Whatever this is called. I forgot what it's called. There's actually a name for this, but I forgot what it's called. Do that. We still have like 30 minutes left. 20, 27 minutes left before the coffee diary. I know many of you who play Exanima always look forward to that every week. Oh yeah, well, I think we've established our hair part. Do something like that. This tip is maybe a little bit too long. Actually, I don't know. It has to be kind of long for like style points, right? But not like overbearingly long to look at like sloppy, you know? It has to be kind of like neat, you know? It has to be a really good silhouette to the hair. Like, hair is something. So like hair in video games is either, it's a make or break sort of thing. Either the game has really good hair, which is very rare, or like the hair is like Oblivion, right? Where like 99% of the hair looks like shit. And there's just like one selection that looks half decent. And then you have to wait for modders to actually add in any decent hair. That's it goes. I don't know why either. Like, it's really not difficult to make hair look good, I guess. Well, maybe it is for some people, but I don't think it's difficult to make hair look good. Humble brag. Okay, so that's SK. Interesting. Interesting abbreviation for the hotkey. We'll keep the sideburns kind of short because the sides are shaved pretty close, I guess, kind of like my haircut right now. What is Sculptress Pro? I need to figure that out. I've heard of it so many times, so I don't know what Sculptress Pro is. I'm actually taking some cues from my own haircut right now. I would have never added this if I didn't like look in the mirror and like, oh, whoa, I didn't know my barber gave me this. I'll just do like that. I guess that's like the crown, and then that's like, ah. Yeah, I don't know why my hair's like that. That's so weird. But I'll add it anyway for realism. We do want to keep kind of like a chiseled look. So there's definitely a lot of structure, right? There's a lot of strong structure and silhouette to the hair. It's not just like placed haphazardly. Almost like squarish in nature. What is my dog doing? It's like looking out the window. And he's also digging. Yeah, since the sides are sh buzzed, I guess like the hair down here should be pretty darn close to his scalp. Shouldn't really have this long bit here. Really like the only length we're seeing is up here, up on top. I need some more geometry here. Might actually give him like a I don't know. Really thinking about giving him a ponytail out here. But I think that might be a bit much for I feel like the corporate world frowns on long hair. So I guess we won't give him a ponytail because it's probably against like dress code. He'll get sent to HR if he has a ponytail. We need to figure out how his head transitions into his neck and then all of the cybernetic implants and stuff. It's gonna start like blocking out and defining where stuff is going to go. This is his ear. That's gonna make his ear look a little bit more like an ear and less like whatever this is. There we go. That will just like move it around a bit. I wonder if I should give his ears like cybernetics too. Give him put some like cybernetic implants on his ears. That would make a lot of sense too. Why is ZBrush lagging? What the heck? Am I getting input lag? figure out some details here. Don't know if we actually will do them, but his neck is a bit thick. Maybe it's like the chunkiness back here. Bit too chunky. We're gonna give him some really interesting proportions. That's the beauty of cyberpunk and cybernetics. You can just go crazy with what your character looks like. So he's gonna have like metallic plates down here, so that. I don't know. Here's his belly button. How many abs does a human have again? Wait, I need to look this up. Where's my reference? Okay. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I was right. There's 3 abs here, and then there's like 2 down here. All right. How many abs? I wouldn't know. I don't exercise. I should. I kind of want like parts of his neck to be see-through. So there's gonna be like holes and stuff where you can see circuitry. I have topological, and that's why. Much better, less input lag. Okay, I gotta go. It's actually it's meeting time. It's Exanima coffee dairy time. Thanks everyone for coming. Catch you guys later. Hopefully we can do a longer stream tomorrow. Bye.